The Ministry of Disaster Management and Refugee Affairs, MIDIMAR, was established in 2010. One of its core mandates is the management of disasters that occur in Rwanda. Due to its topographic and demographic characteristics, Rwanda is vulnerable to natural and man-made disasters. These disasters, more often than not, result in the loss of lives, injuries, damage of infrastructure like bridges, schools, markets, and other properties. They also cause agricultural losses, environmental degradation, population displacement, destruction of houses, crops, and so on. MIDIMAR, through the project called Building National and Local Capacities for Disaster Risk Management in Rwanda, aims to put in place and strengthen systems, policy frameworks, and build capacities at all levels for reduction of disaster risks. It's a five-year project funded by UNDP, which also provides technical expertise and advisory services. One of the main activities of this project is capacity building for disaster management at all levels. This comes mainly in the form of training programs, development of institutional systems, coaching, mentoring, and technical assistance.
At national level, the trainings target the MIDIMAR staff and focal point from line ministries, and the objective of those trainings are to help the involved staff to improve the quality of interventions and to be able to implement the National Disaster Management Policy and National Disaster Risk Management Plan. At local level, the project targeted the DDMCs, District Disaster Management Committees, and the Sector Disaster Management Committees to be able to implement what is needed to be implemented at their level, district and sector level, in a disaster management policy and disaster risk management plan, but also to implement district disaster management plan.
The project has benefited a range of stakeholders through the training programs conducted by MIDIMAR. Among them are the National Platform for Disaster Risk Reduction, National Disaster Technical Management Committee, and MIDIMAR technical staff. Aside from trainings at national level, the project has also substantially supported training programs which benefited a number of district disaster management committees and sector disaster management committees, including local leaders at cell and mudugudu levels. This will really help us at district level because those trainings were provided at all levels, bring together stakeholders from district level, sector level, cell level up to the mudugudu level. It's actually a tool to sensitize local residents about disasters they are prone to and get them involved to take measures for prevention and mitigation. As part of the strategic capacity building of districts and sectors, MIDIMAR facilitated the deployment of district disaster management officers called DDMOs. As of this year, 10 out of the 30 districts of Rwanda have already benefited from these disaster risk reduction activities. These districts are Nyabihu, Burera, and Rulindo in Northern Province, Nyamasheke, Muhanga, and Nyamagabe in the Southern Province, Kwamagana and Nyagatare in the Eastern Province, Rubavu and Rutsiro in Western Province.
At national level, this project is supporting MIDIMAR and line ministries in mainstreaming disaster risk reduction and management in their policies, plans, and programs. As we know, the EDPLS2 stated that disaster risk reduction and management is a cross-cutting issue. So we have to mainstream, to incorporate this aspect in other policies, plans, and programs in terms of disaster risk reduction and management. And it is in that context that some officers are recruited and sent to different districts. The district disaster management officers, they are sent there to support the district to implement their plan and to make sure that in each sector, agriculture, health, education, they are considering disaster risk reduction and management issues.
The DDMO from Kwamagana district shares her experience in working with the district authorities in the area of disaster management and disaster risk reduction. She's explaining what they do to help the district handle with disasters issues. First of all, we did capacity building trainings to foster behavior change towards disaster risk reduction. Second, we sensitized residents to relocate from high-risk zones. More than 580 families were residing at high-risk zones. Specifically here in Kintuzi sector, more than 99% were relocated to safer zones. We established the DRR clubs in secondary schools.
Barazamutse bari mu mudugudu twashyizeho kandi n'amatsinda mu mashuri
mu bigo 192 schools here in Rulindo district. All boarding schools here in Rulindo are equipped with firefighting equipment such as extinguishers, sand that is used to stop fire, and we have trained staff on how to use those equipment. Schools have also got insurance for fire incidents.
Bikagira kizimyamwoto, bikagira imicanga irunze mu kigo bashaka kwitabarisha mu gihe habayeho ikiza cy'inkongi y'umuriro. Ibigo byinshi kandi byamaze no kubona ubwishingizi bw'inkongi y'umuriro.
We have trained youth through the National Civil Education Program for those who completed secondary education. We expect them to become good ambassadors for the rest of the community. All teachers were trained in disaster management, but especially directors were trained on firefighting in collaboration with Rwanda National Police. Two staffs were trained at each health center, since DRR is every Rwandan's responsibility. All hospitals and health centers are equipped with lightning rod and fire extinguishers, and two staff at each health center and hospital were trained on firefighting. Telecommunication companies were also urged to protect their masts by installing lightning rod, because it was realized that transmitters can be source of lightning, to which Rulindo district is very prone. Nyabihu district is another district that benefited from DDMO's activities. The mayor of Nyabihu district confirmed the remarkable progress made by the district and the population in disaster management over the past year since a DDMO was deployed in his district.
Since Midimar appointed a professional officer in charge of disaster management to our district, it became for us an important support. We are grateful to Midimar. Though as a district we have to handle all issues affecting our population, it has been an advantage to have a district disaster management officer who deals at a daily basis with all related matters. As a result, there has been tremendous achievement regarding behavioral change towards disasters in our community. We counted more than 600 residents living in high-risk zones. Most of them were reluctant to relocate due to traditional belief that they couldn't leave their ancestors' land, irrespective of alarming risks. However, thanks to the daily sensitization conducted by that DDMO, finally residents changed their mind. Some of them moved from high risks to safer places over their own means, without any help. Others who were poor embraced the move but couldn't make it to relocate. So Midimar again supported us with iron sheets. Disaster risk assessment carried out revealed that environmental degradation was the main factor of disasters that have devastated our district. So strategies adopted to enforce environmental protection considerably decreased disasters in Nyabihu district.
Residents of different districts where DDMOs worked also confirmed the better change in their behavior on the way to prevent and reduce disaster risks. I'm among those who relocated from high-risk zone. My house was destroyed. I moved from there, I was given iron sheets, now I'm in a safe place, no risk of landslide. I believe there will be no disasters again. My house is now resilient, and with my kids, we are sure that even though it rains cats and dogs, we can't be affected. I once again say thanks to our government for the commitment to come on aid whenever disasters affect poor people like us. Thanks to Midimar, they are always ready and accessible. We are now safe here. Thank you. The project also supported Midimar in sustaining its disaster communication systems, which strengthen its capacity for disaster monitoring. The project provided airtimes to 832 disaster monitors in all the 416 sectors in the country. The disaster monitors report on a daily basis any potential or actual disaster happening in their respective sectors, which enables the Midimar to mobilize and undertake corresponding response actions in a timely manner. Raising public awareness is another key activity supported by this project. Midimar increased the participation of people in disaster risk reduction activities in their respective local communities through the awareness raising activities and different campaigns conducted with different groups like clubs in schools, committees of disabilities, and women associations. The local communities are reached with the support of the districts and the DDMOs. Key awareness messages on disaster risk reduction are also being disseminated regularly through TV and radio shows, publicity spots, and live talk shows.
We have basic knowledge on risk reduction since we are trained. There is also a club for disaster risk reduction. Precaution measures like availing sand in the school compound were taken in order to be able to respond when fire incident eventually occurs. Fire extinguishers are also available. Since our school is located in sloped mountains, we also planted windbreakers to mitigate disasters which can destroy buildings. Our staff is also trained in disaster management. We have also disaster insurance for all our infrastructures. We have undertaken measures for disaster mitigation inside the school and in its compound. We do water channeling, mitigating erosion, and when we observe sometimes may cause disasters, we warn our school authorities. Like when we realize that some roofs are no longer resistant, we warn authorities to operate necessary refurbishing. Our club also carries out sensitization to the rest of the community by reminding local residents to consider resilience and safety. There are regular meetings of different clubs inside the school, and that opportunity helps our DRR club to share knowledge about DRR.
Ibiza bigabanuke.
After getting informed, trained about disaster management, we know what a disaster, the causes, and prevention strategies are. Especially for us disabled people, we now know we can also take part in disaster prevention programs. We also got informed that disabled people should be rescued first when disasters occur. We didn't know, but now we know. The project also ensured a more active and well-coordinated disaster management. Steered and led by Midimar, the National Platform for Disaster Risk Reduction has become more active and visible. While there are many notable achievements, owing to the support of this project, which is geared towards helping the government of Rwanda to strengthen its disaster risk management capacity, enhance preparedness and reduce risks, there is still a long way to go and gaps to address so as to achieve the goal of building disaster resilience in the country.
We are now on the second year of implementation of this project. And we think that the objective is not yet achieved, as this project is set and designed for 5 years. We can't stop awareness for the public, because the risk will remain there, the vulnerability will remain there, and the exposure, even if we are reducing the exposure somehow, but the awareness on disaster risk reduction is an activity that has to be continuing. And we think that it's important that we extend this project to other districts, because we have issues and risks and vulnerabilities in all districts in Rwanda.
Some of the districts which have not yet benefited from the DDMO's activities requested for DDMOs to be deployed as well. For instance, Huye and Musanze districts, which are prone to disasters. The rapid urbanization of their towns and climate change are the major causes of disasters occurring in their districts.
The district officer having disaster management under his duty is not effective because he mixes with several other responsibilities. He scattered in various tasks here and there, thus not able to focus on disasters. However, if there was a special officer dealing with disasters on a daily basis, would be an advantage to our district. Hypotheses say that Musanze town might be constructed over underground water, so a disaster specialist could help to carry out related studies.
Furthermore, there is a need to build upon early successes of the project, sustain on its achievement, and scale up on some activities, such as on continuous capacity building, public awareness activities, and support to disaster monitoring.
The project is supporting Midimar to conduct the risk assessment, the risk and vulnerability assessment, and to produce some maps. That activity is very important because it will help Midimar and other stakeholders to orient their activities in the right places, the right areas, because all vulnerabilities and risks will be mapped. We will know what has to be done in any district and sector, especially in prevention and mitigation, in the right areas and spaces.
There is also a need to sustain public awareness campaigns so as to continuously sensitize the population on the importance of a risk reduction and disaster preparedness culture to avert or minimize disaster impacts. It's worth noting that since the beginning of the Building National and Local Capacities for Disaster Risk Management project, the identified households in disaster-prone areas are 47,474. According to the report given on 12th June 2014, a total of 38,731 have already been settled and relocated to safer areas in different districts. Midimar owes the willingness and realization of people in the importance of being relocated to safer areas to the increased awareness and sensitized population on disaster risks. As the project moves on its second year of implementation, Midimar reiterates its commitment to fulfill its disaster management mandate. It also remains grateful to partners and donors for the continuous support and cooperation. Special thanks to UNDP in Rwanda for this project's support. As project implementation continues, together with its partners, Midimar remains steadfast and committed to achieve the results set under this project. It also continuously embarks on more aggressive resource mobilization work to raise the required resources to fund and support all the project activities.